24 years into our democracy, and residents of an impoverished rural village in KwaZulu-Natal are still in the dark. The only form of basic service they've received over the past two decades are pit toilets. Well, residents say they feel alienated from society.
May 17th, 2011, another election. Excitement and anticipation as South Africans counted the hours before voting stations opened. But for a small village community tucked away in the heart of Zululand, the mood was different. They wanted to boycott the election as they were still without basic services. The SABC highlighted their plight.
Life is hard in this area. There has been no service delivery since we began voting in 1994. We don't have roads or bridges, and schools are far. Our children cannot cross the rivers to get to school.
7 years later, we returned to the village, only to find little has changed. These pit toilets are all these residents have received from government. Our situation is dire, but as we are going to elections, people will come here with their big cars to get us to vote, but after they forget about us. A single water tank was erected, but locals remain without water for months. Another challenge is getting to school. It takes 2 hours on foot. And when it rains heavily, children cannot cross the stream. Many are forced to drop out. I had to drop out of school because I don't have parents and my grandmother cannot afford school fees. But also, traveling to school is far. I get home after dark. Not only is the area without the basics like water and electricity, getting services like clinics and social services is just a dream. If someone is sick, we have to hire a car. They charge 600 rands to the clinic and back. As the May 2019 election draws closer, it means very little for the community. Whether they will go to the polls is uncertain, as they don't expect their crosses will improve their dire situation. I am Mhlongo, SABC News, Ulundi.